The liver is something that is only one by this side of the body. And you know what? This liver could be affected by a number of things, ranging from the issue that has to do with alcoholism, which can tilt you to what is called liver cirrhosis. Let's look at the liver. If you look at this, this is the normal shape of the liver. This is also the normal color. Of course, you eat liver and you know the brand of liver, all right? The way, you know the texture of the liver, all right? That is how you could see this. Fine, that is normal. There's a gallbladder under it, all right? However, there could be a situation where there could be damage to the architecture of that very liver, and it will turn like good. Just picture a loaf of bread exposed under hamatan. You know how it used to be? Perfect. So you can have such a case. This is what is called liver cirrhosis. It has become like that kind of dry bread. It's not going to perform the functions that the liver should be able to perform. So under this situation, you will see the man having yellowness of the eyes. You see the man's tummy sometimes, you know, getting big. And of course, the person will definitely look sick. Such a situation where this very person has a problem, in the modern technology, a person who has liver failure, secondary to this kind of liver cirrhosis, secondary to issue of PLCC, primary cell liver carcinoma, or anything that can bring about liver failure, that person can benefit from liver transplant. But you know the interesting thing about liver transplant? Quite unlike kidney transplant, where you're going to take one from the person and give to the other person, 100%. But everybody has one liver. So if you give out the whole, why would you also survive? But the good news about liver transplant today is that a portion of the liver of someone can be given to a compatible recipient. And the most interesting thing that happened in liver transplant is that if this is cut and given to this person, within 6 weeks to 3 months, the two liver, both the one given and the one that was removed, can grow back to equal portion. An interesting thing. And that's why you see a number of people right now receiving liver transplant and can still be able to live again. That is one good thing that has happened when it has to do with a man having liver-related problem. The issue of liver transplant is possible. Now, in our world, the two, both the donor and the recipient, can still be able to live normal life again. A good news, isn't it? And one thing about this is that it has less of rejection tendency compared to kidney and some of the other organs. Now, we go further. Also, on the issue that has to do with kidney failure, a lot of things can make the kidney to fail. And that's why I want to encourage everyone. Be careful of what you take in the name of drugs, in the name of supplements, in the name of whatever that goes into this your body. Seek professional advice about them. Because whatever misses this very liver, because whatever you take in, it goes to the liver tries to manage the toxicity of it. If it couldn't handle it, it will push it away. Where is it going? Right to the kidney. And if the kidney could not be able to cope, it will pack. That's why we are having a lot of kidney failures in our environment today. But still, in the midst of such unfortunate situation, there is hope. Today you can do what is called kidney transplant when in a situation the kidney fails. And don't forget that the commonest cause of kidney failure in our environment is diabetes. Manage that diabetes well to preserve your kidney. Nevertheless, when the worst case scenario happens, you can still benefit from kidney transplant. Of course, you know that before now, people fly abroad and say that I'm going to go and do kidney transplant. But the good news it is to our people today, at least in a very possible proof, you don't need to fly abroad again to have kidney transplant done in a number of cases. Because right now, Zenith Hospital, St. Nicholas Hospital, and a number of hospitals here in Nigeria has been able to do kidney transplant successfully. and the patients are living. They are all living and doing well. So this is one major innovation coming up, and the good news is that some of these things can happen in this country this time.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye.